Hope everybody is doing great. Welcome to your first year class. The first poem of your syllabus. Let us start today. The first poem of written in your syllabus or given in your syllabus, that is A Little Grain of Gold, which is actually written by the poet, the writer Rabindranath Tagore. So first of all, we'll go with the introduction of the poet. Rabindranath Tagore, we cannot say him only a poet. He has so many multifaceted personality that it is difficult for us to judge him in a singular criteria of being a poet. Okay, so the first of all, let me introduce you the poet or the writer at the background of this special poem. Rabindranath Tagore was born in 1861 in West Bengal, and he actually died in the year 1941. Remember, all of you, introduction of the poet is must, because when you write down the annotations, you have to write down a little bit of the introduction, annotations and answers as well, a little bit of the introduction of the poet as well. So you just keep it in mind. Don't think that it is one of the wastage of your time, that you should not listen to the introduction of the poet. It is necessary. Poet, author's introductions are necessary. And he was the first winner of the Nobel Prize in among the Indians. First Indian to win the Nobel Prize. And that's what one of the great, very great, you can say greatest achievement for the Indians. At those times, it is very difficult. Even these times also, in these times also, it is very difficult to get a Nobel Prize. Nobel Prize is one of the prestigious one. It not normally ordinary people could not get the Nobel Prize. So, and he got that prize for the compilation of poems known as Gitanjali. If you ever get the chance to read out his Gitanjali poems, one of the greatest versions he has written over there, and where he believed in the complete surrender to the God. So that was, and he has written the relationship of the God as well as with the human being, what the God want from the human being and what the human being want from the God. So he mentioned it out very in a very dramatical, or you can say poetical way, and it was very heart touching. So this is the one, that's why it has got the Nobel Prize. Every ordinary work could not get the Nobel Prize. Now, about his multifaceted personality, here you can check it out. He was not only a poet, he is a writer, musician, painter, educationist, so many things in one person. So we can understand that he is not an ordinary person. He is an extraordinary one. And he wrote short stories, poems, plays, critical essays. By criticizing the government and all, he wrote very much good critical essays. Now, what happened is that here, you can check it out, he wrote the national anthem. You know very well national anthem, Janagana Mana, what you recite in your school every time. Normally in many of the schools during the daily assemblies, the national anthem would be recited. So national anthem being written by the greatest poet Rabindranath Tagore. And next is that he expanded Shanti Niketan. Shanti Niketan was actually one of the school founded by his father. Whose father? Rabindranath Tagore's father. And then when Rabindranath Tagore visited Shanti Niketan at the age of 12 years, he has decided by himself that when he grown up, he would definitely expand Shanti Niketan. And it is being established in West Bengal, and he expanded that Shanti Niketan. Shanti Niketan has a different way of teaching, because he doesn't believe in education confined to the one classrooms. He has a lot of variety of ideas to establish a different mindset for the education and a different mindset of the students. And he wanted a very good atmosphere, not only the good atmosphere, but also he wanted a very open atmosphere for the students. Like in Shanti Niketan, the classes can be conducted under the tree. Not necessary that they have to confine to one classroom. That's what I wanted to say, that the students can go outside in the playgrounds and can have the classes. The nature can teach them well, according to the writer. And he established in that purpose. Now, for related to your particular poem, A Little Grain of Gold, he has actually one, like he has given a task for us to understand some questions to get into the mindset to understand the poem first. What God do? God gives and forgives. What does it mean? God only gives. Does he take anything from us? Does he really need something from us? No, God does not need. So what the poet is saying? God gives and forgives. Forgives means to simply just forget out, to just apologize, okay, leave it. He won't take the revenge. He only gives and he forgives. If you done something wrong or something like that, you ask for the forgiveness to God. Definitely God forgives. So the same thing, he only had a habit of giving and forgiving. And now the next comparison he has given us, the mothers. Mothers also gives. Nature also gives. Nature means here, like maybe in your school days you have learned about one of the tree. Poem is written as the giving tree. In that particular poem, it being shown that the boy was very friendly with apple tree, and he goes to the tree and he actually talks to the tree. So he was very lonely, so he wanted to play on the tree. He plays with the tree. He took the fruits of the tree. He took the branches. Lastly, at the last moment, he cut the tree and he made the boat for that. He took the sticks of the branches of the tree to construct his house. He took everything from the tree. And then the last, at the age, at the end of his you can say old age, when he was too old to migrate anywhere, he come back to the tree and he sat on the stump of the tree. Completely he cut down the tree, but he sat on the stump of the tree. That actually, that particular poem shows the giving nature of the tree. So it is not only tree, the nature. The nature gives us everything. It does not take from us. It only gives us. So he said that here, that nature also gives. Now next is that people prefer to be takers. What does it mean? Like people only wanted to take something from the others. They just don't want to give anything to the other persons. They want only to take. How much it can be possible, we can go ahead and take. That makes them what? Selfish and greedy. They become very selfish because they want to take, and very greedy because a small amount of anything, not necessary money, anything would not be enough for them. They want more and more. So they become selfish and greedy. Now, the most important point to be remember is that be able to take, one must give. Means if you want to take something, first of all, get ready to give something to the others. It doesn't mean only in the matters of money. You can help someone, even you can share someone's problem. You can try to help only just in one, just giving a glass of water to some other person can also be counted as one of the selfless act. The person is in need. Like suppose you are traveling in a bus and the bus is completely filled up, and you luckily you have a seat, you are sitting on that bus seat. Suddenly one of the elder person came, elder than you, and he or she was standing just beside you. Would you have the guts to get up, and would you have that selflessness to get up and give the seat to the person? If yes, you are a good one. If no, you have to change yourself. There is a need to change our attitude. Because if you give something to someone, definitely God himself will give you. There is no need for that person to return the reward. God will reward you. Okay, forget about the bus seats and all. Just once imagine out, you are waiting for your turn in any clinic or any other place where there is a lot of crowd is there. Many people are sitting and empty chairs are not there. Someone who is of old age, or someone who is having a lot of fever, or somebody, like not necessarily old age people, any of your same age, but she or he is suffering more than you, would you like to exchange the place? Would you like to give? Yes, you should. That shows you have humanity in you. So always remember that if you want something for you, then you should give something to the others. And always remember that don't expect reward from the people. God is there. He will reward you. So the main criteria of the poem, or you can say the main theme or background of the poem, is that it is written as a little grain of gold, but actually it shows the whole selfish and greedy nature of the human being. So before starting the poem, let me get a quick recap for all these things, whatever we have understood today. First of all, we have got the introduction of the poet Rabindranath Tagore. He was born in 1861 and died in 1941. Then he got the first winner of the Indian first winner for the Nobel Prize. And for what he got? For the Geetanjali, a compilation of the poems. And he is not only a poet, he is a writer, musician, painter, educationist, so many things. And he wrote short stories, poems, plays and critical essays. Next, the most important thing to be remembered is that he was the person who wrote our national anthem, and he expanded Shanti Niketan in West Bengal. It is one of the premises for school, as well as now the university is there. He expanded, but who founded? His father. And before starting that, let me give you this quick introduction of the background of the poem. It is that quick recap, okay, of the poem. God gives and forgives, mother gives, nature gives, but many people prefer to be the takers, and this taking attitude make them selfish and greedy. And what is that? The most important line to be remember: be able to take, one must give. In the next class we'll start the explanation of the poem. By the time, try to observe all these things. Take care. Have a nice day.